everybody feels the same. Why's nobody talking about it? What a wise woman said. She said that we're most afraid. Not about darkness, but all about love. Remember just yesterday. All the journey.
I'm Kate Tucker and I'm a visual artist. I normally work in a studio. Actually, I work across two places. I work kind of half in the country and half in the city, which is pretty great. And when I'm in the city, I work in a small studio that's arguably a little bit squashy. So I have everything that I'm working on squashed up right next to everything else, which I actually think is quite nice. You get very immersed. And when I'm in the country, I am converting a studio at the moment out there. So it has been just moving my stuff around with me, sometimes in the lounge room and sometimes in the bedroom and sometimes somewhere else, sometimes outside. And yeah, just making my work happen wherever I am. I try to be quite disciplined in how much I work and when. And there are two and a half days a week where I go to the studio and I work. And those days are for all the different aspects of what I do. So I don't put pressure on myself to just produce. I like to think of them as the days when I, you know, make inquiries that I want to make, or I go and look at art, or I speak to people, or I just go and sit in my studio and think about what I'm doing next. But because I don't have all the time in the world, like most people don't, I guess I do feel that slight time pressure, and that means that often I'm pretty productive, and usually it doesn't take very long at all once I'm in the studio to just head off and start making work. I have a little boy who's nearly three, and I think unusually my whole visual art career kind of happened since he was born, or since I was pregnant with him. So I did have another career prior to that. I was a designer and an illustrator, and I used to do a lot of different creative work, and I always worked really hard. But I do think being a parent has made me a lot clearer on what it is that matters to me, and much more decisive. And I guess I just don't really have time to beat around the bush. I want to go in there and do exactly what is important to me. I do think that having a child has given me an incredible sense of perspective, and I'm so incredibly grateful for those moments I have with just me and my art, because, you know, it's a life that's jam-packed full of wonderful things, but it's rare to have them separate from each other. It's quite a hard thing to do. So I guess when I go into the studio, I try to really, I guess, just concentrate on what I have around me and just give way to ideas and try to forget the world a little bit. I think the things that are important to me when I work are very varied. It's a whole range of things that position me where I am within my work. So it might be a current investigation I have with a material, or it might be something that I'm trying to say. It might be a painting I really want to finish, or a show that I'm imagining having in a couple of years. Or even just that there's a new album I've got and I'm listening to it, and it's just really getting me moving really quickly and really excited. And I guess there's a lot of different things that intersect that create that sort of creative situation. And I feel like if I just always follow what I'm interested in and I'm always brave in what I try to do, then there's always something fascinating going on. And I've never had a problem being inspired. I never get bored or lost with my work. I just try to concentrate on not trying to do too much, I guess. I think that my career so far has been perhaps a little bit unusual or unconventional. I feel really fortunate, actually, that I came to art a little bit later. I'd already tried really hard to find creative satisfaction and not quite found it, not quite felt like, you know, I'd found my thing. And I was working as a designer, and actually I had a feeling that I was not quite in the right place, but it was really hard to isolate exactly what it was that wasn't sitting right with me and what I needed to do to move closer to what would make me really happy. But I'd always loved art and I'd always wanted to be an artist, but somehow I guess I let myself feel that that was too hard, or that it wasn't going to work, or that I'd left my run too late, or something, you know, any of those excuses you can find. But I actually hurt my back really badly and I had to stop sitting at the computer, and I'd already felt emotionally like I was disconnecting from what I was doing as a freelancer anyway. And because of that injury, I had a full kind of reassess, and I decided no, I'm not going to focus on the reasons why I shouldn't do this. I need to just take the risk and go to art school. As soon as I went to art school and I started part-time, I just felt like I was in exactly the right place. I was just overjoyed. I felt so incredibly lucky. And in a way, I think I was also fortunate to be doing it a little bit older and having already had some experience with working with my creativity. And I guess I was strong and I was ready to take that risk of saying, no, this is what I'm here to do, and you know, face the difficulties. It's really hard to, when you're a kid, to go in there and say, this is my art, this is my practice, this, I believe in it, it's valid. I think it's really hard, and I really admire everyone who does it. And for some people it sort of rolls on in a way that's satisfying, and for others it doesn't. And for me it was just a little bit odd because I went to art school and I loved it, and then I had my son, and after I had him I just started painting. It came very easily. I felt so lucky to be there with a paintbrush, and I had a show that went well and people wanted my work, and I guess it started the ball rolling, and I thought, wow, maybe this could actually happen. You know, maybe I can be an artist. I've been very lucky for a number of reasons. One of them was that I think one of the biggest barriers to being an artist is money, and the fact that you're pretty unlikely to make much, or that's the perception. And it's hard to go and do postgraduate study. It's hard to do any study financially. And I was very fortunate to have a supportive partner and to be able to just go and do that and commit myself fully to art school for a year. But I've also been lucky in other ways, in that somehow I have found people and people have found me who have just made things fall into place, and I felt really incredibly supported. And I felt that I was able to find people who appreciated what I was doing much sooner and in a much more profound way, I guess, than I expected. One thing that happened that had a pretty profound effect on my career was when I met Missy Higgins through a friend, and somehow magically I ended up painting her album cover, and we really connected and are great friends now. But that collaboration immediately was extremely, extremely good. I felt like she really helped me become a better painter. Her insights were amazing, and also just, I guess, having exposure to her own creative process and the way she works and approaches her own work was so inspiring, and I learned a lot from her. When I was working with Missy, I painted her album cover, and I also painted a portrait of her, which I entered in the Archibald Prize, which was selected, which was amazing. And that was an incredible experience, I guess, because not only was painting her portrait a really joyful experience because I really respected her and I felt like I knew her really well and I had a lot to say, but it was also an incredibly timely kind of opportunity for me to extend my painting and try something I wanted to try. And when I was selected and the painting was in the Archibald, I guess so many people saw my work that would never have seen it otherwise, and people who loved Missy, I guess, were really appreciative of my portrayal of her, which was also a very rewarding experience as an artist. So I felt as though perhaps the love that I felt for Missy as a friend and also the great deep respect that I had for her work and her music, I feel that maybe to some extent that must have come across in that work because of what a wonderful kind of experience that whole thing was. I think one of the great challenges of being an artist or committing to making your art is that concern of why am I doing this and what is it for and who am I doing this for? I think I always felt a little bit like it was self-indulgent in some way, or like it wasn't going to be doing anyone any good other than myself. And I'm not sure where that idea comes from really, but I think I did feel that, and I felt as though perhaps I should be using my creative skills to, you know, to do something for social justice or to just contribute in a more direct way, I suppose. But what I realise now, which I think I sort of learnt the hard way by, you know, when I was doing design, I contributed my work, I donated work to people and I did that. But what I realised was that as much as that helped a little tiny bit, I wasn't fully harnessing myself and my own capabilities, and I didn't feel I was really doing what I was put here to do. So I think as an artist, you have to decide that even if you don't really understand what your contribution is going to be, you just have to take the leap of faith and just go, okay, I'm pretty sure that I've got something to contribute here, and I'm pretty sure I'll find a way to do it. And you just have to start. And I think, you know, even as someone who's best known for abstract paintings, I feel as though the connection that people sometimes have with my paintings is incredibly meaningful. And above all, regardless of what other people are seeing in my work, I feel like I've found my language. I feel like now I can express what I need to express. You can't put the cart before the horse. You have to make the statement. You have to create the methodology so that you can make the statement, and then whatever happens to it after that, well, that's not something you can necessarily control anyway. There are so many different ways that you can sort of position yourself in your art, and I only have limited experience, but what has been great for me has been having a couple of shows in artist-run spaces, and actually having a fabulous commercial gallery representing me. You know, everyone chooses to do things in a different way, and it does depend on your work and the context that you really want your work to be in. But for me, it made a huge difference to have the support of my gallery, because they had so much knowledge I didn't have, and they provided support in terms of the context where I could show my work and getting it out there to the world. And those were the things that I really didn't want to be focusing on. I felt really safe there to just go to my studio and make the work and to actually let the rest of it go. And I found that to be an incredibly positive relationship and experience. And I suppose I have felt actually nurtured by them, particularly, I suppose, because I started working with them pretty early on. And I have felt that they want the best for me and my work, and they're just there to do the bits that I'm not so good at. I think if you can get into a position where you have that relationship, then you're really lucky and it's really great. Many artists I know don't work with commercial galleries. They do all of that work themselves, and they have shows in various different spaces, artist-run spaces and not-for-profit spaces, and it really depends on what you want. For me, I really did want to have the support of other people to do some of that stuff. I wanted to just be able to go into the studio and maybe not even open my laptop for 2 days or 3 days. And to me, that's such an incredible privilege. I know a lot of artists who perhaps would like to have a relationship with a commercial gallery and don't. I also know a lot who don't necessarily want that. But I think that if that's what you're seeking, sometimes it's incredibly hard to get out of the studio and to find those connections and to start those relationships up. And I think sometimes the commercial art world can feel quite impenetrable, and it's very intimidating. And I think one of the greatest challenges seems to be early in a visual artist's career, you know, how do I get my work out into the world, and how do I get people to see it? I think it's really important to have a lot of confidence in what you're doing, even if it's only early on, and to start showing what you're doing to people, whoever they are. If there's a gallery that you really like, then make contact with them and start being around them and go to the openings and try and start a dialogue. Other artists who inspire you, you know, start a dialogue with them. And it's about showing that faith in your own practice and saying, I'm serious, I'm here for the long term. And, you know, I'm going to know you one way or another, so I'm just going to go and say hi, and here's my work, and I might only be a year in or 3 years in or 10 years in or whatever it is, but I just want to say this is who I am and this is what I do. I think you really have to show that confidence. I don't think you can really expect anybody else to get behind you if you don't get behind yourself and your own work. In Australia, because we're very isolated and because it's a small country, I think we feel that we've got such a battle ahead of us. And yeah, there's not a lot of money or support going to the arts necessarily. Perhaps there are other countries where it might be easier, or that, at least that's our perception. But I've always felt that I can do whatever I want if I work hard and if I, you know, if I really try and I really believe in it, I think I can make whatever happen. Having said that, you know, there are times when you feel discouraged, and I think in my early 20s I did sort of look around and go, the reality is this is going to be hard. It's going to be hard to make this dream come true. And I think it is. It always is sometimes. But it's about having that really, having that perspective and sort of thinking we're really lucky and we have a great life here and it's an amazing country and there are a lot of amazing artists and there are a lot of people supporting each other. And I think perhaps if you're feeling really alone in what you're doing creatively, it's just important to reach out and find the people who will support you. Because even if you're feeling like things are a bit competitive or a bit difficult, there's always people who will support you and connect with you and who are having a common experience.